We've got 4 kilograms of gold here, Matthew. All right, you know a little bit about gold, correct?
Since 2007.
Since 2007, you've been playing
the
gold game.
That's why I have three, you have one.
That's true, that's true. You play, and I also try to play with it. Yes, exactly.
Always.
So, you have the three, and you know a little bit about the gold game, and you're a true gold investor, and you've had your highs, and you had your lows, and you have a story to tell that I want you to be able to communicate to these people so they understand, so they don't end up like you.
No problem.
Okay,
it wouldn't be bad end up with me. At least I have my 3 kilograms.
I have my three, I have my one. Well, you know, before we go
on, I give you one, don't worry.
Yes, all right, well, maybe you put it in, we play a different game later. But right now, we're playing the game that we're playing at this moment. So, me personally, I'm going to be taking my kilo and I'm going to be converting it to some gold chains to add to my collection in my store with the rest of my kilos.
Yes,
exactly. What are you going to be doing with your three?
Mine, I'm just keeping it as an investment, waiting for the highs, and just selling and cash out.
Selling and cash out. Okay, well, let's talk about that. So, you know what I'm saying? When you're selling and you're buying, you're trying to turn a profit, you're buying at one number, you sell at another. So let's talk about exactly how and when you got your hands on the gold. So first and foremost, today, the price is $43,077. What's today's date? The 16th of June?
16th.
Yeah, 16th, more or less. All right, so 16th of June. $1,339 per ounce, $43,000 per kilogram. Between the two of us, we got 4 kilos, and that is worth about 43,000 times four, right? 43 times four, that should easily be 172. That's $172,000 of cash equivalent gold, right? Gold is the original currency. It's the original foundation of all economy throughout time.
It was always gold, the money, and then they humanity created the
paper currency. Yeah. All right, paper currency and a lot of other things, but at the foundation of all value is gold, right? That's why there's Fort Knox and Federal Reserve, and they all have gold to make sure that they could have something that balances out their paper currency. All right, but we're going to talk about that in a little bit of time. First and foremost, you are at $30,000. When did you get your hands on these kilos? How much were they worth?
I started with
the
kilo around 2007, 2008.
Okay, 2007, this is 2006, this is 2010, 2007's around here. And the value was around $25,000, correct?
Let's say 22K.
22K, so you got your hands on your first kilo, 22K. And then what you did was, from what I understand, you rode the dips.
I played with the dips. Uh-huh. I bought in when the dips were in, and I sold when the highs were high.
Okay, so you rode it. You rode the big game, and you somehow were able to masterfully multiply 1 kilo into three. Okay, and you also brought in other money. You sold your inventory. You sold your beautiful
brand name jewelry,
whatever. In the jewelry business, just like me,
the money goes anywhere, you know.
You know what I'm saying? So, but long story short, you got up to 3 kilos. Now, the way gold is and the way investments work, right? Let's say you got 1 kilo. I'm gonna have to confiscate this for a second.
You could be happy for 5 seconds.
Yeah, thank you. So, 1 kilo is 10,000. Then if you got 1 kilo when it was 10,000, you got the other kilo when it was 20,000, and then you got the other kilo when it was 30,000, it's not that this kilo is what's 10,000, they're all 20,000. You average it out, okay? So you had the 3 kilos, you played the game, and then at any fraction of time, each kilo was worth on average the value, okay? So you were at all 3 kilos on average what?
On average, let's say 30K.
30K. So you averaged out at 30K was your cost, how much US currency you have invested into 3 kilograms of gold. So you put 30K, $90,000 each. Okay, and you rolled and you weighed and you played and you rolled the price all the way to the peak of this chart. Okay? Right here.
2011.
Okay.
1910
per ounce, and it was $60,000 per kilo. Okay, all right, so on average, you know, you roll the dips, you take your losses and your gains, you're about to double your money, and it was feeding you, you were playing around with the gold, you had a great time, it wasn't a lot of hard work, you're about to double your money, okay, so that's where the real story begins. You're about to double it, you knew the chart, you know the game here, okay, and you had the 3 kilos, so the story goes, on the table right at the right time when all the big boys are ready to cash in, and you had it on the table and you were ready to cash in. And what happened?
And then it was this guy standing next to me, when, which I never saw in my life. And
didn't even see him in your life.
And he was like, what are you doing? Why are you selling now? 1900 is going to be 2000 next week. And it planted the greed seed in my mind.
Okay, so everybody understand, okay? The gold, you could cash it in. Where were you cashing it into the Diamond District?
Yes.
All right, was there a specific, we don't want to mention the vendor. We're not doing free advertising over here for that person. But you had it with a vendor that just gives you cash for gold, right?
Checks, cash.
Yeah, whatever it is, all right? There's a lot of those, okay? They love that because they go and they take it to the bank and they get what they need out of it.
Sure, they have their own business.
They have their own business, but so the viewers would know, eventually the gold goes to a bank or a reserve, all right? Sure. Because that's the ones that have no problem giving you paper currency for this metal. Right, it beats that every time for them, so they have no issue. So it's easy to lift it off and get your cash. You're about to cash it in. Somebody told you that the price was gonna go even higher, and you retracted right then and there, right on the table. You had your gold right on the table, and you said no. And you took it back and you held on to it. And unfortunately, even your original instinct was absolutely correct.
And then the guy played with my mind, and then they took it deep.
Uh-huh.
You took it deep, and so since 2011, you could see right now from 1900, right now is like 1340 almost.
Mm.
But right now, you gotta look at the chart now. It's finding support at these levels.
Ah, yes. Well, that's true.
So when it finds the support, then it's gonna shoot up high because
okay.
There is a support.
Well, that's what you think. All right. We already know that you don't know.
No, I know.
You knew, and you thought you did.
The guy made it.
The guy. The guy made him do it, okay? All right? So the guy played with him. He played with his mind. And that's the story, all right? This is one investor, one person, and one game. Please take this. It's too heavy for me. Okay? So one person, one game. Other people play this game, and there's a lot of different emotions involved. And ultimately, greed is the factor that destroys the world, which affects the price, okay? All right, for instance, the reason why this chart looks like this is because of starting with, it was beautiful times, and then it came 9/11, then came the Iraq war for no reason, then came the collapse because of the housing market and all those variable interest rate loans that were made for people who couldn't afford houses, that they should have been able to afford them but didn't, and this and that and so on and so forth. That game, the mistakes of war for no reason, or oil, or what have you, and the thoughts of some guy said, or what we're doing now with this, a lot of other crazy funny money numbers in China and Iran and the tanker that recently was attacked, and so on and so forth. It plays a story with this individual metal, okay? All based on human behavior and greed, and that's why it has a future,
always. It had a past, it has a present, it always gonna have a future.
It always has a future, and that future is never gonna, the chances of it going down to zero are as zero themselves, all right? Simply because if gold goes down, the people who print money buy it, okay? The US government, China, Russia.
Actually right now China and Russia are buying tons of gold each week.
Exactly.
That should tell you something.
Why? Yeah, that should tell you something. Yeah, because, here's my estimate on why they're doing that. They're doing that specifically because they know, all right, Russia, I don't know why, because Russia is on its own journey, but China knows. China has extraordinary amount of debt and printed money laying around. And if people start to cash in or something happens and wobbles with their economy,
that will be the end of it.
Then the gold price, there's a lot of money. There's a lot of money in China, and they're really... At this point in time in our lives, over the course of the future, they're going to take control of the economy. It used to be the United States was the big boy on the block and used to set the price of gold and this and that. In our lifetime, we might see that shift to China.
I don't think so, but we might.
Well, I hope not, all right? Because we love...
Uncle Sam would never let that happen.
Well, Uncle Sam would never let it happen, and we all play for Team America here. But the reality of it is there's a lot of people over there. Okay, I forget how many, but there's a massive amount of people, and they're working very, very hard to catch up. There's a lot of other factors it involves. social factors, how people treat one another in the United States, religious factor. Here we got better religious foundations. They don't have that many in China. All this other stuff, all these factors result in win or lose. But they're rising. Everybody knows they're rising. And what matters is when it pertains to this metal is that they're going to take control of the economy in a certain way. And if they play the game that they're playing now, the price of gold might take a leap that people don't even understand. Okay? So that might happen, and all these factors are at play. So, what am I telling you? First and foremost, it's good to have a little bit of gold. You don't have to ride the dips and sell at the high and all this other stuff and have a kilo if you don't know what it is. But it's nice to know exactly how it works.
The big boys always have 10% of their portfolio invested in gold, no matter what.
No matter what, because they want to be able to, if everything goes down, they want to be able to at least rise over here. Me personally, I love gold because right now, this is about, $172,000 worth of gold. I could easily put my hands on it and walk out the door. I don't need to go to the bank if it's closed or open, or send a wire and show anybody my ID, or do this or do that, or have a big sack of cash. That's 172,000 or whatever it is, okay? Or in some backpack like a rapper. I have my gold. I could stash it. I could do whatever I want with it. I'm free, and I know I could cash it in and turn it to whatever I want, wherever I want.
You are a golden boy right now.
I'm a golden boy right now, okay? I'm a golden boy. I'm going to be a golden
even
boy.
Even chains.
And the chains, too.
Rolexes.
Own it in chains. Own it in this for the average person. If you have some gold, you're tied into this chart, and you're tied into a drama. You're tied into a history of gold. So, with me and Matthew are saying, any final words, Matthew, for these people?
Always have some gold on the side. For if no matter if it's in gold coin, chains, Rolexes, you still have some money sitting that it could be turned into cash.
And it's fun to ride this chart. The future could be very, very interesting. If humanity is good, the price will go down. If humanity is bad, the price will go up. We've got to figure out what kind of human beings we're dealing with, okay?
That's going to be next video.
All right. Okay. Which ones do you want?
Which one do you want to give?
Which one do I want to give
you? I want to take the all four.
The all four?
Give me the all four, man.
Give me the all four.
What are you doing with one?
Yes.
I have three. Let me
I'm
have
playing
four.
With it. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
For watching.